NVMe SSDs. These things are probably my favorite thing to happen to computers for quite some time. There's no cables, they're small, and they're extremely quick when compared to your conventional hard drive or SATA SSD. The only problem is you have to have a motherboard that supports it. But what if you could use these on an older motherboard, say maybe an old Sabertooth Z77? The hardware that's sitting next to me is roughly 10 years old at this point. And I know a lot of you are thinking that you're old with me saying that, but I feel old too, because this is the original hardware from my very first computer build. I saved it. That build video still exists. So if you want to have some fun, if you want to cringe at my expense, go ahead and watch my original computer build video. It'll be linked in the description if you guys want to have some fun. With that said though, we're going to get into the requirements for this video so you can follow along with me for this video. So let's get into it. The first is you're going to need a PCI to NVMe SSD adapter. The one that I'm using in today's video is from Easy DIY Fab, and it works perfectly and I've had no issues with it. The next requirement is you obviously are going to need an NVMe SSD. Duh. However, not all NVMe SSDs work with this modification. The one that I found that works perfectly for me was the Samsung Evo 970 Plus. And the last requirement is you're gonna need two USB thumb drives, one that's capable of being formatted to FAT32 and one that has Windows 10 installed on it. So first things first is you do this video at your own risk. I cannot stress this enough. We are modifying the BIOS on the motherboard, which is potentially very dangerous and can leave you with a brick of just a motherboard that will not power on or boot anymore. So keep that in mind. If you are still willing to do it, then continue watching this video. Let's get into it. So with the requirements out of the way for this video, we're going to prepare our USB stick for our modified BIOS flashing. The USB stick that we plugged in needs to be formatted as FAT32. My drive is already formatted as a FAT32 device. Once we have our USB drive plugged into our computer, just drag and drop that modified BIOS into your USB drive's directory. That's all we need to do. And now we have our USB stick ready to flash our modified BIOS. With the modified BIOS on our USB stick here, we need to plug it into the BIOS flashback port on the motherboard. The motherboard has a specific port that the USB stick needs to be plugged into in order to use the BIOS flashback button. So that is the farthest right USB port right here on the bottom. That is our BIOS flashback port on our motherboard. So we're gonna plug it in there, and we need to remove all other USB devices. So if you have a mouse or keyboard or anything else like that plugged into the computer, remove the device from the USB port. And now all we need to do here is we need to push and hold the BIOS flashback button for 3 seconds on our motherboard. It will start flashing blue. If it continuously starts to flash and then starts to get faster and faster and faster, then your BIOS is being flashed properly. If it only flashes once and then turns off, that means there was a problem with flashing the BIOS. Now that the blue light on the back of the motherboard has stopped flashing for the BIOS flashback button, that means we've successfully installed the modified BIOS from our USB stick to our motherboard. So now we don't need this USB stick with the modified BIOS on it. We can take that and toss it off to the side. We're going to take our Windows 10 installation media and we're going to plug it into the same USB port that we used for the flashback button. And we're also going to take our NVMe SSD inside of our M.2 adapter and we're going to plug it into our X16 slot on our motherboard. So we're going to boot the SSD here by just bridging the two pins here. And we're also going to mash the delete button on our keyboard. As we boot the computer, we're going to move over to our screen and I'm going to start mashing that delete key so we can boot into our BIOS here. There are a few settings on the BIOS that we need to change in order to boot our SSD with Windows 10 on it. So we're going to go into our advanced mode here and we're going to scroll over to the boot tab on the BIOS. We're going to scroll down until we see secure boot, and you're going to need to delete the secure boot keys off of the motherboard. If you don't, then the NVMe SSD will not boot properly. We also need to change our OS type to other OS from Windows UEFI. Again, the NVMe SSD won't boot otherwise. And then we need to scroll up to CSM, and then we need to have launch CSM on auto. And again, the NVMe SSD will not boot if we don't select those settings. Once we've done that, we can go to our exit tab and then go to save changes and reset. Click OK. And then we're gonna go back into the BIOS once our motherboard has reset with those new BIOS settings. And again, we're gonna mash that delete key. And then we're gonna go into our boot menu this time, which is F8 on the main menu. And we're gonna select UEFI USB, which is our Windows 10 installation media. All right, so the USB stick has finally awoken from its slumber and allowed us to get into the Windows installation manager here. So we're just gonna click next and click the install button. And then what we're going to do is we're going to select that we don't have a product key for this motherboard. If you have a product key, feel free to enter it in at this time. I don't have one for this motherboard. And I'm also gonna select Windows 10 Pro. And what we need to do next is we need to go to the custom tab. Instead of upgrade, go to custom. And you'll notice that there's only one drive listed here, which is my NVMe SSD. So you should see drive 0 and then unallocated drive. All you need to do is select that drive and then click the next button, and the Windows Manager will take care of everything from that point onward. Now that Windows 10 is successfully installed on the NVMe SSD, I'm gonna remove it from the computer just so I have the NVMe SSD plugged in, and that's the only thing that's plugged into the motherboard. I'm gonna take my screwdriver once again, and I'm going to bridge the two power pins just to boot the motherboard with the NVMe SSD installed in the computer. And you're gonna see just how quick this Samsung 970 EVO Plus boots on this motherboard. So we'll just give it a few seconds. That was quick, wasn't it? So with Windows 10 installed and booted on the NVMe SSD, I installed all the latest updates for Windows 10, the drivers for the motherboard and everything, and I installed the latest firmware for the 970 Plus using Samsung Magician. Just so we don't get any performance discrepancies due to a bad driver or firmware update. So with Crystal Disk Mark open, we're going to give it a quick benchmark to see if the modification has affected the performance of the SSD. And the claims that Samsung makes for the 970 EVO Plus are 3,500 megabytes per second for the read and 2,500 megabytes a second for the write speed. And as we can see in Crystal Disk Mark right now, we are getting 3,440 on the write speeds for our Samsung 970 EVO. So we are getting our advertised read speeds that Samsung claims for this SSD using this modification. And we're gonna see in just a quick second to see if we get our modified write speeds as well on this modification using the adapter. And we should see our result any second now. And the results are, we have 2377, which is very, very close to the advertised speeds of 2500 megabytes per second for this SSD. So the modification hasn't affected the performance for this SSD whatsoever. We're getting full blown speeds on this SSD, which is fantastic to see. So with that said, guys, this is gonna wrap up today's video on how to use an NVMe SSD on your Sabertooth Z97 motherboard. And personally, I think this mod is really cool. This is so cool to get this much performance out of a Sabertooth Z97 motherboard. This motherboard, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, is my very first motherboard I ever owned. And it's almost going on 10 years old now. So that's really cool to be able to use such kind of newer technology on such an old motherboard and breathe new life into it and kind of bring it up to the modern standard of storage speeds. But anyways, that's gonna wrap up today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. My name is Kendall, also known as Wiltshire. And as always, I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, everyone.